A very good afternoon to all the beautiful people.
Greetings.
From America.
Hey.
Welcome to Cape Town.
Cape
Put
Town.
On your dancing shoes. Cape Town welcomes you.
Excellent.
Okay, so now you have already been to Robben Island. And our next stop, it's going to be to the District 6, the Apartheid Segregation Museum, where I will hand you over to Tando. He's a guide, very good guide. He also lives in one of the townships that we are going to visit. I have made reservations for lunch at one of the townships, so you can have the true experience. And then, of course, you have already met the coach captain, Brendan, this morning. He fetched you and brought you here. So I'm going to start off with a little bit of history about Cape Town, the mother city of South Africa. The reason why we call the mother city is because this is the first place that was discovered by the Dutch. So where we are driving right now, this used to be the bottom of the Atlantic Ocean. So this is all reclaimed land.
Wow.
That we are driving on now. So there was great whites swimming around where we are driving now. So I'll take you back to the year 1648, when a ship by the name of the Harlem washed ashore on the Blouberg Beach. The strong southeaster wind, we call it the Cape Doctor. The reason why we call it the Cape Doctor is because we believe that that strong southeaster wind blows all the ailments out of the city. So there was many shipwrecks that took place around this neck of the woods. So 1648, the Harlem comes and the strong southeaster wind blows this ship onto the white sand and it falls apart. Everybody's lives were saved. They managed to save all the goodies that they had on the ship, and they were not quite sure how long they were going to be stuck here. So they started to sow the seeds that they had on the ship, and they then also met the local people here, the Khoisan people, the Bushmen and the Bantu people. They met them here. They were hunters and gatherers. They hunted with bows and arrows, spear fishing. The gatherers of the vegetation, the medicinal plants that grew here. So they were pretty much the people that owned this land. They took the animal skins, they put it in the sun, dried it, and this was their attire. So they lived here happily, and then whenever they saw a ship passing, they would make this big huge bonfire, send a smoke signal to try and get the attention of a ship so that they can get a ride back home. So they were stuck here for 6 months. The local people here also took the clay out of the mountain. They made a foundation. They built a round house with the clay. They took the restios, the reeds, and they bunched them up, and they made a thatch umbrella-like roof over this round rondavel, this hut. So this is where they stayed and lived off the land. So one day, while they saw this big ship, immediately they started their bonfire, and the ship came and stopped at Blouberg and picked them up and took them back home to Holland. They then took out, when they reached home, they took out a map and they showed their superiors, this is where they were stuck for 6 months. And while they were here, they saw many ships passing through. Thanks to Bartholomew Dias, Vasco da Gama, 1487, Bartholomew was the first seafarer to successfully circumnavigate the Cape to find the vital spice route, the sea route to India, where all our delicious spices come from. Thank you, India, for tickling our taste buds. So they went home, they showed their superiors, this is where this where they were stuck for 6 months, and this would be a perfect place for a refreshment station, for a station where all the ships on the way to India, they can stop here and find their fresh fruits, their fresh produce, fresh fruit, vegetables, water, and believe it or not, wine. And the reason why they needed the wine was because the sailors at sea experienced an illness called scurvy. So the vitamins in the wine cured the scurvy. On the 3rd of December 1967, our very own Professor Christian Barnard was the first surgeon, cardiologist, to successfully do the human-to-human heart transplant in the entire world. And he also suggested to his patients with heart problems to have a glass of red wine per day because it clears your veins of cholesterol. So it was medicinal then and it is medicinal now. So every time we feel scurvy coming on, we have 2 bottles of red wine and we are very happy and cured.
Yes.